In 1922, at the beginning of the Irish Civil War, the Four Courts was occupied on the 13th of April. The irregulars arrived, they immediately occupied the Four Courts. One of the buildings they took over was the Public Record Office, because it was, if you like, on the perimeter of all the buildings. They started to take records from the Record Treasury and put them in the windows, if you like, as sandbags. The pro-treaty forces were outside, and they were bombarding the Four Courts in an attempt to get the irregulars out. And at some point then, the Public Record Office was also destroyed by fire and explosion in the whole conflagration that went on. Out of the debris were picked calendars and indexes and fragments of calendars and indexes. Scattered pages of the calendars to the justiciary and other rolls were found all over the building. The presence of explosive substances rendered the work of salvage dangerous, and the reality of the danger was proved by a miniature explosion which took place sometime afterwards in the strong room.
The destruction of the PRO, which had a traumatic effect on the city and on the country, it also had a huge effect on the people who used the records and obviously on the staff. So there was a huge effort made to collect all this material and parcel it up and keep it in good faith. And I suppose it was put aside in the hope that somebody would come along at some stage and open them up and look at them and check them. Those days became months, became years, became decades. And we felt now was an opportune time to take stock and to open these parcels and to see exactly what they contained. And they contain a variety of records, documents, letters, receipts. And I suppose they've taken on a veneer of importance by the fact that they survived from 1922.
Well, essentially everything that we're working with has been in a fire. And so it is, in most cases, as you would expect, there are lots of singed and scorched areas, they're burnt and crispy edges to things, folded documents are scorched along the sides. The heat of the fire actually was like baking the paper documents in particular, and they've become quite dry, they've lost moisture, and therefore they're very brittle, and they're at risk of further damage if people are to try and access and use them. Primarily what we're using here is we're doing a lot of surface cleaning. Everything's very dirty and dusty. We're using a thing called smoke sponges, which were designed for taking soot off walls of burnt buildings. And then the next thing we're doing is we're introducing humidity or moisture back into the documents in a very gentle way to try and help reshape and flatten the documents. Then I'm doing repair on the documents and both paper and vellum. So for us in conservation, it's been a really exciting process. You know, for the team who were working on the project, they were unwrapping parcels that hadn't been touched or opened for 95 years.
We feel it's timely and important for us to be doing this project at this juncture, as we're in the middle of the decade of centenaries, and we're also approaching the 100th anniversary of the destruction of the Public Record Office, which is now the National Archives.
At this time, we're looking at how best to acknowledge the tragedy that it was. And it was a tragedy. 700 years of Irish history went up in flames.